Bienvenue dans votre vidéo inspiration spéciale marketing de réseau et vente directe. Ici Christophe Tamry, propulseur de Leader. Aujourd'hui, vous allez découvrir John Maxwell.
Let's talk about the principle of executing ideas. I forget who it was, but it was the CEO of a company a few years ago. And he said these words, everybody that takes a shower has an idea. He said, it's what you do with that idea after you get out of the shower and dry off that counts. And I thought about that. I thought, isn't that true? We're taking a shower. We're singing in the rain. We're kind of letting our mind go out there. We're just kind of filled with good thoughts and dreams. And oh, wouldn't it be wonderful if, and we've got all those ideas in the shower and we come out and we dry off and we put on the clothes and all of a sudden they're no longer there. Well, what's happened? What's happened is we haven't executed on the idea. Now, to be honest with you, I have a lot of ideas. And a lot of the ideas that I've executed on, to be honest with you, they didn't go very far. They weren't probably that great of ideas. In fact, have you ever been like me, had an idea in the middle of the night and maybe even got up and you wrote it down, and the next morning when you're fully awake, you looked at it and thought, now what does that mean? That wasn't that good. Well, kind of sometimes out of the deep sleep, I've got an idea that I think is good only to wake up and find out it isn't. We've all had ideas like that. But what I'm talking about is following through on the ideas. And there are three things that I do that I think are going to be helpful to you if you really want to start executing on ideas. Number one, write the idea down. Just put it down there. I mean, just as it is. And then look at it, because there's something about visually looking at something that is written that kind of lets you know potentially how good it is. But write the idea down. That is first. Number two, try the idea. I mean, when I say try it, just go out and give it a shot. And it doesn't have to be a dozen tries. Maybe it's just one try, but just go out and say, okay, this is what I was thinking. I'm gonna act on what I was thinking today. Here's where you really execute well. After trying the idea, I call that, there's an expression I use, and that is I call it taking your dog for a walk. After taking your idea for a walk, in other words, what do you do when you take a dog for a walk? Everybody stops, what's its name, pets it. You start talking about your dogs and your pets, and you're getting discussion on taking that dog for a walk. Well, take that idea out there for a walk, try it out, and people are going to let you know whether they think it's good or not. But after a few tries, come back and look at the idea again. Now, not only in light of how you wrote it and what you did with it, but now look and say, how can I improve it? Because what I've discovered is that the first thought is not the best thought. It's just the first thought. Nothing wrong with that, because that's the thought that gets you started. But if your first thought is your best thought, you're not thinking very deep and you're not thinking very long. So you write your first thought down, you go out and try it a little bit, and then you come back and you write it again. I promise you, the second time you write it, it's better than the first time. If it shows promise, go execute on it again. You see, the execution of ideas is a result of writing them down, trying them, rewriting them, trying them, rewriting them, trying them, until you get to where you want to go, or till you get to the place where you say, it's going to work. I've had both things happen. But I know that ideas get better with trial, error, reflection, and correction. That's what you want to do with ideas. Don't let them die. I promise you, if you don't write them down, if you don't try them out, and if you don't try to upgrade them, you'll lose some of the best potential that you could ever have in your life. John Maxwell here. I'm glad you joined me today on Minute with Maxwell.